Today's lesson will be over a constant of proportionality. So let's read our activity. The Texas Parks and Wildlife Department monitors the number of largemouth bass in lakes across the state. The department has to ensure that the population is steady or constant in the state's lakes. That means there should be the exact same number of fish per acre in one lake to another. You don't want to have one lake that has overpopulated fish while another lake have hardly any fish. So at Lake Fort, a biologist estimates there are 490,752 largemouth bass in 27,264 square acres of lake. At Lake Ray Roberts, there are estimated 460,800 largemouth bass in 25,600 square acres of lake. There are 24,120 largemouth bass in 1,340 square acres of Lake Sulphur Springs. Are the number of largemouth bass steady or constant in the different lakes? So we're going to find that out. So before we do that, let's fill out our table, complete the table. Let me get my pen. So in Lake Fork, there are 490,752 largemouth bass in how many square acres? 27,264. At Lake Ray Roberts, there are 460,800 bass in 25,600 square acres. And in Lake Sulphur Springs, there are 24,120 bass in 1,340 square acres. That's a smaller lake, as you can tell. So, using a calculator, determine the unit rate of the number of bass per square acre. So, do unit rate. What operation will we do? Add, subtract, multiply, or divide? Well, we're going to divide it because we're going to break down the square. So, we have 490,752 bass in 27,264 acres. How can I break it down to per acre, to 1 acre? I must divide by 27,264. So if I put in my calculator, 490,752 divided by 27,264, there are 18 bass per square acre. Let's try the next one. 460,800 divided by 25,600 acres, that's 18 bass per square acre. So far, it's pretty constant and steady. There are 24,120 bass in Lake Sulphur Springs. I divide it by 1,340 acres. There are 18 bass per square acre. So our question is, does the relationship between the number of largemouth bass and the number of square acre in the lake represent the same number? Yes, it does. And what number is it, by the way? It is 18. So how do we know? So let's, because we figure out. So, because the number of acres is always multiplied by 18 to find the number of bass. So how can I explain this meaning using the word bass and square acres in 18? So there are 18 bass per square acre. So there are 18 bass per square acre. So if I have 1 square acre, there'll be, I found 18 fish. If I have 2 square acre, there'll be 36 fish. If I have a 3 square acre, that would be 54. So that leads us to a conversation of what is constant of proportionality. Constant of proportionality is the same as unit rate. So the constant proportionality can be found represented by the equation k equal y divided by x. That is why we divided the bass by the acres to find 18. Therefore, the constant proportionality for the lake is 18. Explain its meaning. There are 18 fish or bass per square acre. That means you can multiply any square acre by 18 to find the number of fish. So for example, if the lake had 100 square acres, if I multiply by 18, that means there will be 1,800 bass fish to nibble on. So, you do not need to memorize this. You will always be given it right here in a math reference chart. Constant proportionality, which is the same as saying unit rate, it's just a fancy word for unit rate, is k equal y divided by x. So let's watch this little short video. So as you can tell, the dog is not aware that it's seeing its image, it thinks it sees another dog. So this dog incessantly barked 30 times in 5 minutes. Can you relate the number of barks per minute? So how many times does it bark every minute? Each minute, 1 minute. 30 divided by 5 is 6. So the dog barked 6 times per minute. Therefore, the constant proportionality for the barking is 6. That means if I know any minutes, such as like 10 minutes, it will bark times 6, 60 barks. If there are 12 minutes, 12 times 6, 72 barks. So, for example, so here is example. Cha yelps 20 times in 2 hours. Prowl yelps 30 times in 3 hours. Cha yelps 10 times per hour. And Yarao yelps 10 times per hour. So if we do the mathematics here, as you can see, 20 divided by 2, which is 10, and 30 divided by 3 is 10. That means the constant proportionality is 10. That means the dogs bark 10 times per minute. So the constant of proportionality is 10. How can I get it? I divide y, which is 20, and then x is 2. The number of times depends on the hours, and that's where I get 10 from. So what we're going to do is you're going to be doing two examples now to practice what we just learned. So Mr. Rao's truck can travel about 40 miles on 2 gallons of gas. Make a table and graph to show the distance traveled after 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 gallons of gas. State the constant of proportionality. So that means 1 gallon, 2 gallons, 3 gallons, 4 gallons, 5 gallons. In 2 gallons, he can travel 40 miles. That means in 1 mile, 1 gallon gas, he can only go 20. I think I see a pattern here. 60, 80, 100. Let's graph this now. So, what if he put 0 gallons of gas in his car? He can only go 0 miles. 1 gallon is 20 miles right here. 2 would be 40, 3 would be 60, 4 would be 80, 5 would be 100, 6 would be 120, 7 would be 140. So, here's a question. Do I connect the dot or not? Can you put half of a gallon in a car? Yes, you can. So we are connecting. This is a continuous line. So now let's state the constant of proportionality. Oh, let's see what it says right here in the arrows. So use the formula k equal y over x to find a constant of proportionality. So K stands for constant proportionality equal. He travels 40 miles with 2 gallons of gas. That is 20. So the constant proportionality is 20. What does that mean? Explain its meaning. That means he can travel 20 miles per gallon. That means if you know how many gallons of gas Mr. Rao puts in the car, you can multiply it by 20 to find the distance he can travel. So here's one. Here's a little one with less information that I'm sure you can fill it out. So represent the relationship in a table as a graph and as an equation. James spent $15 for 5 gallons of gas. So let's label the table. So let's see. This is gallons. This is spent. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, $15. So he spent $15 for 5 gallon gas. So how much did he spend on 1 gallon of gas? 15 divided by 5 is 3. 2 gallons would be 6. 3 would be 9. 4 would be 12. So let's label the axis. So what depends on what? The amount spent, which is a dependent, depends on the number of gallons of gas. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, $10, 11, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So with 1 gallon of gas, he spent $3. 2 gallons of gas, he spent $6. 3 gallons of gas, he spent $9. 4 gallons will be $12. 5 would be 15. So, is this continuous or not? It is continuous. Because can you buy a fraction of a gallon of gas? Yes, you can. So, what was the dependent? The dependent is spent, because amount spent depends on the gallons of gas. This is the x-axis, and this is the y-axis. So what is our equation? What's the relationship here? The relationship is times 3. So how would you write an equation in the form of y equal 3 times the number of gallons of gas, or y equal 3x? So what is the constant of proportionality? Well, the formula is k equal yx. So let's go back. He spent $15 on 5 gallon gas. We divide that as 3. So explain its meaning. That means he spends $3 per gallon of gas. So how much will James spend if he bought 12 gallons of gas? So he spends $3 per gallon. So $3 times 12 gallons, he'll spend $36 for 12 gallons of gas. And that is constant proportionality, which is just really unit rate.